Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Let's learn why one needs to choose bases carefully when working with esters. In the top center of the screen, we have an ester. This is ethyl acetate. We're treating it with base, sodium methoxide. What will happen? In our previous video on the clays and condensation, we used an alkoxide as a base to deprotonate the ester and make an esterenolate. That could happen here. The reaction would be reversible, and favor the ester, but we could make the enolate in this fashion. What else could happen? Well, we know that alkoxides are not just basic. They are also nucleophilic. We could attack the ester carbonyl that would lead to a tetrahedral intermediate. From a tetrahedral intermediate, we look for a leaving group. Here's where things get dicey. We could kick out the methoxy group right back out. So that would be a reversible process. We go back to the original ester, but something else that could happen is we could kick out the ethoxy group. That would instead give a different ester, the methyl ester. Now methyl acetate. This reaction actually has a name. It's called a transesterification. We did not intend to modify our ester with our base, but it happened anyway. How could we prevent this? The only way to stop this process is to make sure that the alkyl group of the alkoxide matches the alkoxy group on the ester oxygen. As drawn, we've used methoxide with an ethyl ester, and that can lead to problems. If we instead used ethoxide, then we'd be okay. Note that using ethoxide does not prevent exchange of the alkoxy group. Ethoxide is still a nucleophile. It will attack the carbonyl. The difference is that the exchange reaction does not change the structure of the starting material. We replace an ethyl group with another ethyl group. Okay, so in various reactions of esters, I will almost always emphasize the importance of having the base match the OR group of the ester. The reason for this emphasis is on this slide. If the groups are not matched, you risk having a transesterification reaction and changing the structure of the ester.